First, taxation in the room. To increase the collection of tax, the Sultan raised the land tax. The king's timing was not good. There was a severe famine during this period. To raise the tax at such a time was risky. Many of them abandoned the land and many of them revolted. Then the Sultan shift of capital. Next thing is next shift of capital. Muhammad bin Tughlaq shifted the capital of the empire from Delhi to Devagiri. Devagiri was one the name, but he named it Devagiri to Devagiri. There were two reasons for this. Because Dauladabad was located in the center of the empire so that it can administer its better and can control. The Mongols were constant threat to Delhi. Dauladabad will be safe from Mongol invasion. Muhammad bin Tughlaq ordered the entire people to move Dauladabad. People did not want to leave their home but had to obey king's order. However, the king soon realized and withdrew this order also. He don't want to shift. Let them stay in Delhi itself. Then another one, introduction of currency. Introduction of currency by Muhammad bin Tughlaq. During this period, there was a shortage of silver. So he introduced a token of currency. Sultan decided to mint coins. Coins of brass and copper for day-to-day use. But people bought brass and copper Bohemians. The people made the coins of Bohemians. The kingdom was planted with forged coins, wooden coins. Mohammed failed to check this illegal minting coins of the people. See, the value of money has lost and trade also suffered because the merchants of other countries are countries. How they will get the brass and copper coins and all. Expedition. The Sultan had a dream of widespread victory. He chose to build Kulazans and lead up and activated a gigantic armed force for the region. But the Dazic made his campaign demonstrated a disappointment. That expedition. This campaign was prepared to counter Chinese attacks. He likewise used the idea that the campaign was coordinated against some headstrong tribes in more rebel history. See, he is the name Muhammad bin Kutlay. He ruled from 1325 to 1351. Muhammad bin Kutlay. Because of these three things, shifted capital, collected tax, used the token of currency, minted in copper and brass, that made him really unpopular because of the scheme. He lost the trust of his nobles, the ulema. Ulema means the scholars. Scholars of Islamic, they know they are very highly qualified in Islamic. The scholars of Islam. And the people of his empire. Kutlay was unable to control his empire effectively. He was broken Bengal, Gujarat, Karangal, and other places. Then, after Muhammad bin Kutlay, Firoz Shah became the ruler of Kutlay dynasty. See how he became ruler of this Kutlay dynasty? Let's see. Firoz Shah was cousin of Muhammad bin Kutlay. He gave Itta. Itta means, say, if you want any work to be finished, you pay money, no? And then only they will finish it fast. Like that, Itta means the land given to the officer. Go on in the king's room, he gave Itta, the land to the officer, to the nobles. The nobles in the in his court, in his home. He moved according to Islamic law. Then only he can see that scholars know ulema, the scholars ulema. As a result, the nobles and the ulema became powerful and influence in the Sultan's day-to-day administration. Firoz Shah built many canals, tanks, wells, hospitals, and educational institution. He translated many Sanskrit works into Persian and Arabic. See, it's only Firoz Shah. Let's see about Said and Lodi dynasty.